Schmack-a-ma-gob, everybody. Dr. Fuck here. You're about to watch the Dream Police review I did. But just to let you know, I did a review for At Budokan, and YouTube blocked it. Now, what's odd is that YouTube blocked it on here, but it's not blocked on my other channel. So I put a link below for the At Budokan review. I'm sure all you Cheap Trick fans would like to watch. If you want to watch this, you're interested in my Cheap Trick reviews, so check that link below and click that. You get to see that At Budokan and Dream Police tonight. You know, stuff like this makes me very gun-shy making these type of reviews I'm doing where I add music and videos. I don't get why, you know, I'm talking over the music, but whatever. But it really makes me gun-shy to make reviews, and I have so many reviews I haven't put up yet, I'm telling you, for years on this channel, of reviews I've done from other channels. But I don't know if I'm ever going to make any new ones like the one you're about to watch. Even this one you're about to watch was a bitch to put up, because if you listen closely, you're going to see, I think it was Dream Police was modified. I had to use a different version or a karaoke version or something. The videos for the Cheap Trick Dream Police album, I had to use picture stills because it blocked that too. For those that are faithful to my channel, you know yesterday I put up a classic album review where I talk about the album. I don't add music or video. I will be doing that a lot now. And every month, every first Friday of the month, you're going to get a brand new review. Every first Sunday of the month, you're going to get a brand new Sabbath review, and you're going to get a Cheap Trick review toward the end of the month. I'm not sure what day that'll be falling on. But that's it. That's all I want to say. Click the link below if you want to see my At Budokan. I got my At Budokan shirt on, man. I bought this when I saw Cheap Trick on the 97 tour. What an album, that 97 album. Anyway, enjoy. Here is the Dream Police review. Hey, I'm back with another Cheap Trick review, and this month I'm reviewing my favorite Cheap Trick album. Yeah, I know I said all those other ones were my favorite in the past reviews, but this month this one's my favorite. And seriously, it really does fluctuate with all those albums, you know. First one, In Color, Heaven Tonight, Dream Police, man, they're really at par, man. I think they're all fucking amazing in their own little ways. They're all different. You know, this one lends a little more toward Heaven Tonight, which was my favorite album last month. Yes, you know by the title of what I already mentioned, Dream Police, that's what I'm reviewing. The Dream Police. Let's do this. The Dream Police. Now, what I'm going to do now on all my reviews, and I believe I did it last month with Budokan, I got to plug this. Stiff Compilations. It's called a Still Competition. I think I've been calling it Stiff Competition this whole time. I've been reading this book chapter by chapter. I read, you know, the first album I read, and I didn't give no credit to Mr. Robert Lawson, which is a shame, and In Color, and also Heaven Tonight. I've been referencing this book, but I never did it. I think I did it on the Budokan. I'm pretty sure I did. And I had this cool dude, Robert Lawson, do both my podcasts. He did the Vieira Vault, talking about this, and Cheap Trick, which is awesome. You need to listen to it. And, man, the details this guy's got. And he just recently did a review of... what album did we review? Oh, the 97 album with Robert Lawson on the Rock and Metal Combat podcast, which is, believe me, one of my favorite podcasts we've done. Because this guy is awesome, and this book is awesome. You should get it. He also did a book on Nazareth, which I will be getting soon. But I took little notes, and I put it in my head. I don't have no paper here. When you get to the Dream Police chapter on this, it's a long story before he gets into the album, which is really cool stories about shows they played and stuff like that. So, man, I can't I can't recommend this enough. All right, Robert, you can send me the check now. Just kidding. Anyway, so yeah. All right. So fuck it. Let's get into it. Dream Police. This is an album that was done, ready to be brought out, but Budokan then exploded, and they had to put this on the shelf. This album took about a month to do, because I read in this book, and it was put on the shelf, and according to the book, this is the first time Cheap Trick was accused of overproducing, and I don't know what the hell they're talking about. This shit's produced perfectly. Overproduced or not, it's fucking epic. I love this album. Like every album that precedes it, man, every song is so good. And this one, man, is like, man, oh my God, you'll see when I go into the songs how great this album is. And look at the album cover. You got this mannequin on the floor. And as he said in the book, on the back, it has like Robin's Hand on the Floor, The First Casualty. And I always love this. I used to have this. I went to a record store when I was a little kid, when this was out, and they had a little display. It was kind of like a pop-up thing up there. And I said, please, can I have that, sir? And he said, $10 or something like that. And $10 back then was like $100 now. And I bought it. Fuck it. I went there to buy an album. I ended up buying the pop-up instead. I was such a big fan, still a big fan of Cheap Trick at this time. And it's amazing. And I know... coming up with future interview reviews, I'm not going to be so kind to the albums coming up, except maybe the next one I love a lot, or maybe it won't be the next album that the next review on. Stay tuned next month to see what I review. Will it be All Shook Up or something else? Something tells me it'll be something else. But what can I say? This was delayed. I remember as a little kid reading about it in magazines. I remember reading about Gonna Raise Hell and stuff like that, and I'm like, oh my God, I can't wait to hear this. And the first time I ever heard something off this album was, well, obviously Need Your Love from the Budokan album, but also when I saw my very first concert ever was at the Budokan Budokan tour at the Miami Highline, May 18th, 1979. My father took me. I hope I'm not repeating this story because it's so cool. My father took me to that show. You know, my father's not a rock fan or anything, and he's very conservative, and he told me, you know, after the show, he said, oh, the only good guys in the band was Rick and Bunny. He didn't like the other two because they had long hair, and he didn't like me because I started to grow my hair long at that time. He made me cut it many times, and here we are, man, next year, can you believe it's going to be 40 years since I saw that show, and the Rockets opened up, so technically the first band I ever saw was the Rockets. And I liked them a lot. I went out and bought that album that has Turn Up the Radio and the Fleetwood Mac version of Oh Well. I'm going on too long, huh? Do you want me to get into the songs, or are you guys interested in my backstory? I hope you are. But, yeah, so here you are. I heard I Know What I Want for the first time at that show at the Hi-A-Lite. They played I Know What I Want, Tom Peterson singing it. And I was, like, blown away. I was like, oh, my God, I can't wait to hear that on the record. And I was telling all my friends the next day at school, dude, Tom Peterson sang a song that's going to be on the next album. It's going to be awesome. It's an awesome song. So, you know, and now we all know it. But that was the first time I ever heard it. And is that a long enough intro to the songs before to get into the songs? I would think so. So let's go into track one, Dream Police. Dream Police, oh my God, I love this. It's one of their popular tunes, and man, I can't get sick of this song. It's fucking awesome. Originally, I think I read this in the book. This was on the first album. They recorded this song for the first album, but it never made the cut. And I believe the middle section is from a song they had called Ultramental that you can hear in... I think Please Mrs. Henry or Down on the Bay, one of those two that's on the box set. Sorry, Robert, I know I just read this and I forgot, I'm getting old. But yeah, this is an older song that they redid, and it's beautiful, and I can't show you the video. They made three videos for this song, and YouTube will block it, because I already did a Dream Police review that's been blocked on this other channel I had where I did various bands, and that was blocked because of the video footage. So what I did, as you can see, I get away with it. I'm showing you picture stills from the video. And man, I love this song. I love the middle section. And just so you people know that aren't veteran Cheap Trick fans as far as going to shows, if you want to catch a guitar pick, this is what you do. During Dream Police, Rick Nielsen, during the part where he goes, "I try to sleep, they're wide awake, they won't let me alone," he has a hand of picks. And when he says, you know, when he goes into the guitar solo, he throws the handful of picks, I believe, to the right side or the left side, according to him, of the stage. And he does a little solo, walks to the side, grabs another hand of picks, throws in his crowd, then he throws it in the middle. If you're close enough during Dream Police to the stage, guaranteed to get a pick or 20. I got a healthy pick collection from Rick Nielsen because I know his moves, man. But anyway, what else can I say about Dream Police except I love it. It's a great title track, a great way to start the album, and let's go to the next one.
Now, classic rock in the best sense of the word from Cheap Trick.
Way of the World. This one was written by Robin Zander and Rick Nielsen, and this is my favorite track off the album. This is kind of like, to me, kind of On Top of the World Part 2, in a way. It's got that same vibe. Beautiful fucking singing. I love the harmonies. You know, I've been running. And the way Robin Zander opens this song, it's like operatic. What a voice. Another great example why this guy's my favorite singer. I absolutely love how he kicks off this fucking song, man. It's so amazing and very, I don't know, Beatlesque meets, I don't know, ELO or something. It's just pure power pop perfection. Yes, three words I say a lot during these reviews because it's the truth. These guys are perfect with the power pop. And again, you're looking at picture stills of the video that I can't put up. And I remember seeing these videos back when the album was released. I think it was Don Kirshner's rock concert. And I'll never forget, man, watching this as a little kid and seeing Rick Nielsen give the finger in the video. And this was on TV in 79. I was like, holy shit, they allowed this on TV? I mean, back then, they wouldn't allow stuff like that. I don't even think you can show the middle finger now on network TV. But man, what can I say? It's my favorite track off the album. And man, spoiler alert, there's not a bad song on this album. But it's definitely my favorite. I love it. I can't stress enough how much I love Way of the World. I never really compiled my favorite Cheap Trick songs, which I will, and put it up on this channel after all the reviews are done. That's if I'm still alive, because, oh Jesus, it's going to take a long time to put these all up. But I bet you anything when I compile it, I wouldn't bet you anything, but something tells me it'll be in my top three, maybe even number one. I can't really think now, what's my favorite Cheap Trick song? This one's definitely one of them. Way of the World was originally called See Me Now. All right, let's go to the next track. The House is Rocking with Domestic Problems. This one written by Rick Nielsen and Tom Peterson. Rockin' tune. Saying "Oh Boy" a lot, where we know there's a song before called "Oh Boy." What can I say? This is probably the most rocking song, the most guitar-oriented song on the album. Rips, man. This song was called at one time "It Must Be Love," and there is a version of this that has Rick Nielsen on vocals, which I've never heard. Buddy Carlo says, according to the Still Competition book, his wish list was to have that as a bonus track on the CD remaster, which I haven't talked about, and I will talk about at the end of the show, the CD which I have right here. What can I say? It's, like I said, killer song, dark subject matter, to a pretty rocking tune, you know. And again, the man of a thousand voices, you know, heavy, and then he's like singing like, you know, he has that like kind of low tenor voice during the verses. Just a perfect rocking fucking song. Absolutely love Dallas is Rocking with Domestic Problems. So let's go to the next one. Gonna Raise Hell. Oh man, do I love this one. Probably my second favorite off the album. And as you can see here, here's a video I made. You can see the video complete on this channel, Cheap Trick Tube. Just scroll down and it's, I believe, the first video I ever put up on this channel. Man, what can I say, you know? And I was so anticipating this song since I heard, you know, this title in a magazine. I was like, I bet that song rules. And boy, I would have won that bet because it does rule. Xander, one of his greatest performances, especially the middle section when he's screaming, "Mother!" And I always heard the story that while he was recording that vocal, "Mother," at the same moment he was screaming that in the studio, the Jim Jones massacre was going on, where Jim Jones was feeding Kool-Aid to the people, and there is audio footage of him saying, "Mother," talking to the moms that didn't want to feed their kids Kool-Aids, "Mother, trust me," like this. But Robert Lawson said, "I don't think that's true," so there you go. But I did read that somewhere, I just can't remember where. But man, and then it goes into this long, like, instrumental thing, and the solo was done in one take. And man, and it goes into like this disco feel toward the end, and there is a disco remix to this song that was never released that I would love to hear, man. But man, what a great fucking song. Great long epic tune to end side one. Absolutely love it. I don't know what else to say except let's flip the album over and go to track one on side two. With You Tonight. Man, what a great, great pop song. It borrows some riffs from a song called Under the Ice from the 1969 album Nas, by the Nas. You know, and I'll Be With You Tonight is also rewritten from a song called Hot Tomato, where they use some of that song on Taking Me Back on Heaven Tonight, and the other part of the song is from I'll See You Tonight. I'll Be With You Tonight. That's a song that you can hear, I believe, on YouTube. I know I have a copy of it with the original singer, Zeno, singing it, Hot Tomato. And, or Feeling All Right. I don't know. Sometimes they call it that, I think. But it's a great, great, this is a great fucking song. And, you know, Joey Ramone covered this song, and he does a great version of it. You can hear it on YouTube. It's amazing to see, hear Joey Ramone do a Cheap Trick song. I don't know about you, but I'm a huge Ramones fan, so just to see him give homage to Cheap Trick is, to me, the shit. Rest in peace, Joey. I miss him. And another thing I find very coincidental about this song is producer Tom Warman. He said in an interview that he likes to leave his least favorite song second to last, which I find weird because, man, think about it, like Stiff Competition was second to last on the last album, and well, second to last on In Color, it was Southern Girls, I think. Those are awesome songs, but that has nothing to do with the song. What I find coincidental about this song is that this song, I'll Be With You Tonight, you notice, you know, they say tonight a lot on this album. Now fast forward 5-6 years later, he produced Motley Crue's album Theater of Pain, where side two starts with a song called I Need a Lover Tonight, and tonight is said a lot on that song. I just find that very coincidental. Thought I'd throw that in. No, Robert, that wasn't in Robert's book. That one I came up with myself, bruh. Anyway, alright, let's get to the next track. Oh man, the beautiful ballad, voices, and who's playing acoustic and lead guitar on this is Steve Lukather, which he wasn't credited. But what a beautiful, beautiful ballad. I remember when I first got this album, I was like, oh, this is going to be a number one hit, no doubt. This is going to be the biggest Jeep Trick song ever. It's such a perfect ballad. But no, it didn't work out. And the way the song starts with all the whispering, according to the book, you can hear clearly in the whispers, Kiss sucks. So I got to listen to it again. Put on my headphones to hear that. And also heard, not in the book, but other places where they mentioned bands. So it's just kind of hard to make out for me. I got to put it on headphones to make it out. But man, this song is just beautiful. It's gorgeous. It's just a great fucking, it's way better than The Flame, if you ask me. And The Flame hit number one. And why this didn't get huge, I don't know. Cheap Trick was on such a roll at the time. You figured this song would have exploded. But no, it didn't do that well. I mean, still a concert staple at most of their shows, which is cool. But absolutely love it. I love the arrangement of this song. I love, you know, the solo is cool by Steve Lukather. Every fucking note is beautiful. And it's just beautiful. It's just a nice, dreamy ballad. And what else can I say about voices? Oh, there's originally Tom Petersen sang this song. I'm not sure if there's a recording of it. There probably is. But Tom Petersen was supposed to sing lead on this song. And for whatever reason, it turned out to be Robin Zander. But man, that would have been odd to hear Tom sing this. Be interesting to hear it. Hope one day I get to. All right, man, let's get to the next track. Writing on the Wall. Yeah, definitely like a filler track, but a killer filler track. God damn, I love this one. This one like starts off kind of like Hello There with that riff, and it's got a lot of bells and whistles. You hear like a lot of sound effects in this song, and cars, tires burning rubber, and then you got the guy that used to introduce Cheap Trick in there during this little middle section where, all right, Tokyo, all right, Los Angeles. They just threw in a lot of, and it's got like the kitchen sink thing to a rocking fucking song. I absolutely love Writing on the Wall. I love the way Sanders sings it. Like I said, I love every fucking track off this album, and this one's no exception. Could I say my least favorite? No, actually not. I would have to say, and I hate to say it, but my least favorite's the next one. I Know What I Want, though. Tom Petersen debut lead vocal on here, and I love this song. Don't get me wrong. I think it's rocking and everything, but the only critique I can say about this song is, man, there hasn't been a Cheap Trick show I've been to since Tom returned where they don't play this song. And to tell you the truth, I'm kind of sick of this song live. It's a great song, don't get me wrong. I like it. But man, Cheap Trick has so many other songs that I'd rather see that. And I know that at many shows they throw out the Waiting for the Man song, the Velvet Underground cover with Tom Sings lead. But for some reason, every time they play South Florida and I'm there, they don't throw that one out. They throw I Know What I Want. And then every time, man, I hear those opening tracks, I'm like, oh man, okay. All right. I mean, I'll get into it. It's rocking and everything, but eh. I think there's a version of Robin singing this song. I think I read that in a book. But, it's a, you know, like I said, I don't hate any song on this album, but this one is my least favorite. But it was awesome seeing it for the first time at the High Line. That was very special, so that's the only time it really, really grabbed me. But also the Lap of Luxury tour. I mean, I don't know if I mentioned this. I probably will mention the Lap of Luxury. I went to go see Cheap Trick at this place called City Limits before Lap of Luxury came out, and I had no idea Tom Petersen was back in the band. Pre-internet, Cheap Trick wasn't all over my favorite magazine, so they came out and there's Tom Petersen. I was like, oh shit, Tom Petersen's back. And when they played I Know What I Want that night, I was like, hell yeah, I welcome it. Tom Petersen's back. So there you go. That's all I got to say about that. So let's go to the last track on the album. Need Your Love. Yes, we all know this one from At Budokan. And, but, I don't know, I tend to like this version more. I like, I guess I like it, you know. I think they did a great job studio-wise. And Robin sings so beautifully. Wasn't there a Donna Summer song back then that would say that? Need Your Love, I think. I don't know. Maybe I'm wrong. That just popped in my head right now. But anyway, I love this goddamn song. Just to get off subject matter for a second, back, you know, a couple years after this album came out, I was really into the new wave of British heavy metal. Really loved all those bands, and I would go to import stores and buy these albums, and one of the bands I love so much, I still do, called Raven. I went to go see Cheap Trick at a... There's this thing called Sunfest in West Palm Beach. And I'm all the way up front, and this lady next to me says to me, "Hey, you look like you're into heavy metal." And I said, "Yes, I am." She said, "Well, you ever heard of a band called Raven?" I said, "Yeah." She's like, "This is my husband, Mark Gallagher." I was like, "Whoa!" It was this guitar player of Raven standing right there. And I was like, "Dude," you know, I told him, "Hey, man, you know, I was about to go see them in New Jersey at a Hurricane Relief Festival, like in a week or two." And we became fast buddies. And me and him were up front. And that night, Cheap Trick played a lot of early stuff, like LO Kitties. And I believe they played TV Violence. And he was nudging me. I was nudging him. And here I am jamming to Cheap Trick with a guy that pretty much idolized, you know, Mark Gallagher. And so I go to New Jersey the next week, and his brother, John Gallagher, I saw Raven perform, they're amazing. John Gallagher comes out to the crowd, and I go up to him, and I go, "John, I just met your brother a couple weeks ago at a Cheap Trick show, and I told him I'd be here," and he goes, "Oh yeah, he told me about you, come on." So he took me backstage, and there was Twist's sister, Anvil, T.T. Quick, The Rods, all hanging out, and they took me backstage. And I went up to, you know, John, he's like, "There you are." And they were both telling me incredible stories about Cheap Trick, seeing them in England back in the day and seeing them at festivals. It was so awesome. But fast forward a little bit more, my band got to open for Raven on two different occasions, one here in Florida, one in Puerto Rico. And we became very friendly. And they do a song called Take Control. I think it's Take Control, Break the Chains, one of the two, where they do a long extended jam part. And when they played the Puerto Rico show, they said, "Ralphie boy, check out what we do during Break the Chains, the instrumental part." Because they played shit like I Don't Need No Doctor from Humble Pie and all that shit. Well, they threw in that Need Your Love riff with that riff that. And they were looking right at me, and I was like, "Oh my God," you know, it was so cool. So, yeah, here I am with this band I loved as a kid, and now we've reconnected, and we've become good buddies, and all because of Cheap Trick. Long story, right? But hey, it's a long song. So I absolutely love it. I love the jam section. Another thing I also can't help but notice, there's a Nirvana song, I believe it's called On a Plane off Nevermind, where it gets real soft, where they're doing this little thing in the middle section, and then Kurt Cobain comes in and does this during that little quiet part. I can't help but think they borrowed that from Need Your Love. And Kurt Cobain actually said in the liner notes of Insecticide that Nirvana was nothing but was a cross between Cheap Trick and the Knack. So I can't help but think that little piece of On a Plane, I think it's On a Plane, it gets quiet and then that loud guitar comes in. That's Cheap Trick, Need Your Love, all the way. So there you go, that's all I have to say about Dream Police. I hope you enjoyed it. Boy, I blabbed a lot on this one. And here we go, this is the bonus tracks on the CD, which are a live version of House is Rocking with Domestic Problems, Way of the World, a live version of that, Dream Police version without all the instruments, those, you know, the orchestra. and I believe Good Night Now. I don't have my glasses. Go buy it and you'll find out what the last track is. But I don't know if I said this before, but I'm going to say, I don't care if I said it before. This needs to be said. I don't like bonus tracks. If you're going to put bonus tracks on a CD, put it on a separate CD. I like to listen to a CD how it came out on the album. I want my album, my CDs to end like the albums. If you're going to add bonus tracks, put it on another disc. Don't ruin my experience. So these bonus tracks, to tell you the truth, they're okay. Oh, I Know What I Want is on here, a live version. And I believe it's way later from Daytona Beach. Because I know that was a B-side to, I think, Don't Be Cruel or something from Lap of Luxury. So that's it. That's all I got to say about this fucking great album. My favorite Cheap Trick album this month. And goddamn, rightfully so. It's a fucking masterpiece. I love it. So till next week, next month, will it be all shook up? Find out next month to see if it is. Thank you so much for watching us. Subscribe, people, please. Make me feel good that I'm doing this, because I love talking about Cheap Trick, and I love the people that love Cheap Trick that are checking this out, and especially the ones that go, hey, I like that guy. He knows his Cheap Trick. All right, guys, so that's it. Till next month, thanks for watching, man. Later. This video has been brought to you by Miami Metal Merchant. For your metal needs at competitive prices, visit MiamiMetalMerchant.com. Tell them Dr. Fuck sent you.